59 teams from 33 countries just in the finals. I mean, that really tells us that tech is widespread all around the world, and the ambition to do amazing things with technology is increasingly being democratized.
Pakistan has the highest still birth rate all over the world. Our solutions is a wearable belt. All the data, including the fetal heartbeat and fetal movements, are sent to the mobile application for the mothers to view at home.
Our drone can fly, scan the farm, and conduct a health crop analysis, and then they can produce recommendations based on the given evaluation.
We are a facial recognition platform that reunites migrants and refugees who are separated. We really base it off of Azure. That's where we host all of the database. We train the data set with a lot of people from places with high volumes of refugees.
Images are often not described very well for visually impaired or blind users. We tackle this problem by having an artificial intelligence.
Selected. A dog at a beach wearing sunglasses. Image.
That automatically generates image descriptions for the images you're looking at.
Babies that are hungry cry in the same way, no matter where in the world they are. iCry2Talk is a real-time baby cry translator that translates the baby cry, associating it with a specific physiological or psychosocial need.
Stelios is hungry.
Does it need a hug? Does it need a diaper change? And then we display the result at the screen of the parent's phone with an image, text, voice, and sign language message for hearing impaired parents as well.
Robotic prosthetics can cost from tens to hundreds of thousands of dollars, mainly because they use complex neuromuscular connections. We've taken all of that connectivity and we've put it so that the camera identifies the object and the onboard computer does all the work.